Greetings, fellow humans. So, another package from PCBWay has arrived. This should be a new revision of this board. This is actually not from PCBWay. This is from Seed Studio, and in this video I'll be comparing the quality of the two boards just to see how different fabs compare. So, let's open this package. So what do we have inside? Okay, so unlike last time, they are just loosely packed in this sort of pouch. So last time I received them in a vacuum sealed wrap with bubble wrap on one side, but that's okay, it's not a big deal. So let's have a look. Nice and purple. I really like the solder mask. It's not bad at all. If this would focus. Focus for me. Thank you. Yeah, so it's pretty neat, I would say. Is it focusing for me? Nah. Well, anyway, let's now have a look at the... Does it at least focus at the QR code? Come on. Yeah, well, that is a QR code. Anyway, let's see how well the drills are aligned with vias and the solder mask and all that sort of stuff. So as you can see, the drills are not quite exactly in the middle. For my purposes, that's very sufficient. I don't think there is much of a solder mask between the pads. Oh, look, they put the tracking code in the middle of the chip. That's very convenient. That means that the tracking code will not be visible anywhere else. That's something I like to see. Because I'll show you with the board from Seed Studio, the Seed Fusion, they just put the tracking codes at the bottom of my bottom side, so I was not quite impressed with that, but then again I didn't tell them otherwise, so it's really to be expected. Yeah, well, I like the alignment of the top face. Now let's see what the bottom face looks like. Oh no, that actually looks very good as well. That is not bad at all. It is a little bit off, like yes, of course this wouldn't be IPC class 3. I would need to pay extra for that, like you can see that one little via in the middle being pretty misaligned with its drill, but it's okay. Not a big deal. Electrically, I think this will be perfectly fine. And here is the QR code, which by the way will not work because it's inverted in colors and mirrored in symmetry, so two violations of the specifications. If it would be just inverted, then most readers can deal with that, but if it's mirror image, then there is very little chance that that will actually work. Oh well, that's fixed in yet another revision, which I'll maybe print, depending on how this one will work. Yeah. Well, anyway, let's have a look at the other boards, at the Seed Studio boards, because they are a bit more expensive, especially the shipping. Yeah, also my vias are covered here, but that's, you can still see how they are drilled. So again, no solder mask between pairs. That's okay. I mean, if you have a solder paste, then it will stick to the copper anyway. And if you solder by hand, then that's should be fine as well. As long as you use plenty of flux, the surface tension should just stick to the pad and leave the other pads alone. But well, bridges can always be fixed. Alright, and for the bottom side, here you can see the tracking number is just here. That's, I found that a bit rude, but I didn't tell them otherwise, so it's okay. And on the bottom side you can see, maybe you can see through the solder mask, that the drills are again not perfectly centered with their vias, but the ring is unbroken, so electrically it will work just fine. Yep, well, so that's pretty much all for this board. Yeah, the surface finish seems nice. It's the immersion gold option, which I believe is just Enig finish. Yeah. Oh well, this will be fun to solder. But that's probably for a different video, because that will be a very challenging task with just hand soldering and, you know, with soldering iron and spool of lead-free solder. Oh well, that will be fun. So, oh yeah, also one thing I want to show was this little cutout for my USB port. That looks pretty clean as well. Yeah, that's very nicely routed. No sharp edges that I can see. In fact, I can't even see where it was snapped. Like, it's very smooth overall. Like, there is not a single blemish. For example, on these boards, on the Seed boards, you can see a little tab in here where it was broken from the panel. But nothing like that on the Arrow board. That's just perfectly routed all the way around. At least no blemish I can see. Oh well, yep, so that's probably all for this video. I might show the result when I'm done with soldering. What is that thing? What is that thing? Is it a lifted pad or something? No. Surely not. Oh well, I'll look at it more closely. But that's okay. It's fine. It's. I like the boards. The solder mask is really beautiful purple. It's, yeah, I know that purple is sort of the trademark, not trademark, but like its signature solder mask for one other prototype board manufacturer over in America, but oh well, that's not a big deal. Yep, oh well, that's all for this video, and I might show you how it looks when I'm done soldering. In the meantime, be good.